I'm a professor of medicine. I'm the director of men's health for New York University. And my role is to take care of patients, teach medical students, and oversee the facility. Well, you know, I view sleep disorders as a foundational condition that affects the overall wellness of my patients. And I view sleep disorders and sleep in per se as important as food and water. So if I expect my patients to be well, I expect them to have a normal sleep pattern. Sleep apnea is the most common of the sleep disorders that have very significant implications for morbidity, overall mortality, and its impact on multiple organ systems makes it vitally important for me to evaluate, assess, and ultimately treat patients. Its impact on obesity, its impact on sexual function, its very important impact on cardiovascular disease, neurocognitive disorders, and mood make it essential. Sleep apnea affects anywhere between 30 and 50% of patients, especially men, maybe 15% or more of female patients, a much higher percentage in individuals who, for example, are overweight, people who have a complaint of fatigue. As patients get older, as a result of aging, menopause, pregnancy, a whole host of conditions which increase the risk for sleep apnea. I think in evaluating individuals with sleep disorders, you need to make it seamless. You need to create a program that the patients can follow easily. And I think that when I say seamless, I mean access to care and access to testing. If the testing is complicated, by which I mean you need to have a office sleep study, a hospital sleep study, that's a barrier that most patients are not willing to do. If, on the other hand, they can do the sleep study in their own home, it's very accessible. If the equipment itself is uncomplicated, that is, you can't expect patients to put, you know, devices in their nose, on their head, on their chest, and expect them to comply. If you can keep it simple, for example, on your wrist or your finger, then I think you have an opportunity to make a quick and accessible diagnosis. Now, it's important to appreciate that there is a role for hospital in-house testing. The complicated sleep disorders, the sleep disorders that are associated with unusual symptoms, potential seizure disorders, or leg abnormalities or neurologic disorders require an in-house test. However, the home testing is an excellent validated screening test that, when positive, actually permits you to go to the next level, which is a treatment protocol. I think that the results of sleep tests are actually very simple to explain. You can, or at least I try to explain, that the patient has a certain number of episodes in the nighttime when they're actually holding their breath. And in the process of holding their breath, their oxygen level drops. Their sympathetic tone, the part of their nervous system that gets activated under stress, increases, causing an elevation in their blood pressure, an elevation in their heart rate, and over time puts them at risk for a lot of conditions, primarily cardiovascular, but less known and less appreciated, a whole host of metabolic disorders, from diabetes to other conditions. I think sleep disorders are so important and they affect so many different areas of disease that every physician needs to be aware of the impact of sleep disorders and in particular sleep apnea in their patient population. So the ear, nose, and throat doctor who has to deal with the patient who's snoring, the cardiologist who has to deal with the patient who has heart failure or arrhythmias, the neurologist or psychiatrist who has to deal with mood disorders or cognitive function, and certainly the family practitioner and general internist needs to be very familiar, very knowledgeable in the area of sleep disorders. If you ignore sleep apnea, you cannot affect a very positive change in the overall health of your patients. And so it becomes a critical factor to evaluate.